Adobe Premiere Pro CC 2018 Panto. Hey, what's up guys? Welcome to my YouTube channel, Digital Creations. In this tutorial, we are going to learn how to use Panto in Adobe Premiere Pro CC 2018. So let's get started. Guys, first open the Adobe Premiere Pro CC 2018 software, the latest version of Premiere, and then open a new project. So I just grab drag and drop these two clips here, guys. I just select this this slider to see the better result of this video clip. Guys, here we go. In this lesson, we are covering the pan tool. So let's get started. Just see here in the toolbar, we see the pan tool. Just short key, hit the letter P, or simply click here, pan tool. And guys, you see here the pan tool. And before start using the pan tool, here you see the timeline display setting. Just click here and make sure to show the video keyframes here. So just hit click and select this. So guys, here you see the video line. So guys, here we can select with the help of selection tool. So this video line, we can decrease the opacity of the video or clip. So you see here this opacity of the video going down. Guys, you see here, I just decrease this opacity. Basically, this video line is used for to decrease or increase the depends what you need, depend on the opacity. So decrease the opacity with the help of this video line. Okay, now guys, select this. Guys, here with the help of pan tool, pan tool is basically used for adding the keyframes in the timeline or in the clip. So just click here, guys, and click one. Just grab it. So guys, here you see the just play this clip. Guys, you see here the opacity is lowering, fade out the 100% to zero. So with the help of pan tool, we can easily fade in or fade out and add the keyframes in the clip. So you see, this one is another clip which is I'm using in a video one track. So very easily we can fade in and fade out with the help of this pan tool, because with the help of pan tool, we just add the keyframes. So again, just put the one keyframe here. Okay, now guys, just check it, play this, and again. So guys, we can also use this pan tool for audio to increase or decrease the levels of you see the levels of opacity in audio levels, to change the audio levels in an audio setting. So this one is quite easy to insert a keyframe in video. Again, hit. Guys, let's have a look in a audio panel. Just check this clip. Okay, now guys, I'm going to adjust the audio line, audio levels. So just decrease the audio. So with the help of pan tool, just a little bit decrease this. So very easily we can use this audio line, just fade in out. So guys, you see here, this setting is good. So this keyframe is fade out, and again I just 100%. So here you check. Check guys here. We just fade is this audio levels and with the help of pen tool. So here again we just drop down this here. So guys, very easily we can adjust the audio levels also with the help of this pen tool. So we just add some keyframes and change the levels of audio levels also. Increase the audio levels, decrease the audio levels, this audio line here with the see the difference, guys. Guys, this is very easy to add keyframes in audio and video also with the help of fan tool. So guys, keep watching my YouTube channel Digital Creations, and if you like my videos, just hit the like button and share my videos, and keep watching my videos. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.